You're gonna find out if you and your partner are truly meant to be together by dating other people. This week, it's ladies first.
Oh, hell no.
First of all, I'm gonna tell you like this. I really don't approve of this.
Ooh. Hollywood feels threatened. It could have been anybody. Hollywood was gonna feel away.
It's time to go.
It's a very, very severe situation.
My father had a stroke in December. His condition was declining.
I want you to go out and have a good time.
Mike acts like he just doesn't care. I feel like he needs to get uncomfortable and stop being so cocky.
You trying to keep seeing what it is.
I'm not trying to see what it is. I'm saying I had a good time, okay?
Oh, yeah?
To have someone listen.
I'm telling you right now, you better hate your date. You better hate it.
We've been so in love for a minute now. Let's make it efficient. Let's get down. Say some vibes. I do. For you.
This week, we're changing things up. The men will be going on dates with other women. You ready for this?
I don't have a problem going out there and see what it is.
Okay.
I feel you.
I'm nervous that Mike might actually like dating, so I don't want him to like it too much because I want us to stay in a relationship, but I do want him to experience it.
Ashley, how are you feeling about that?
I'm okay with it. Because after he proposed, it was something that he said he wanted to do.
What did he say?
That he wanted to see other people.
Okay.
So, I want him to have his wish.
I said that because I was scared and I was trying to push her away.
I wasn't scared to be with her for the rest of my life. I was scared to fail her because she deserved the best. And I wanted to make sure I was at 100 to give her my best.
So let me come back here just for a second because I want to make sure that all of you remember why we're here. You're in a long-term relationship and you're either stuck or you're refusing to move. Struggling to answer a very important question. Is this the person I should commit to spending the rest of my life with?
Originally, Hollywood and I didn't get married because of his fear. Now, we're not married because of my fear. I'm kind of conflicted because I struggle with knowing what it would take for me to be all in.
Dating other people is partly about meeting someone new, but this process is going to help you examine your current relationship and confront your fears about the future.
I would definitely marry Mike today, yesterday, every day of this week. I love him.
Marriage is not something I think we need, but I'll be with her forever.
That's not enough.
By the end of this process, you're gonna be ready to make a decision. Is it time to move on? Or is it time to put a ring on it?
Again. No, I'm playing.
Ulysses and Mimi, considering the emotional significance of what's going on with your family, I think the most appropriate thing to do is to really put your relationship first. Let's not have Ulysses go on a date right now.
I mean, I totally understand. It wouldn't be the proper thing to do, and more important, like, my mind on my dad, period.
Due to the circumstances, Ulysses not going on a date was completely the right decision to make because we need to focus on everything that is transpiring with my father.
I really want you to practice what we talked about, turning to each other and hold on even when you feel like the wind is blowing the hell out of you. I think being with each other is what you need most.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Y'all have fun.
Yeah. Go have fun.
Let's move on. Obviously, we all come with the past. But when it comes to our relationships, if you live in the past, it's not gonna help you build a solid future. This week, I really want you to move forward from your past to make room for a more successful future. Take something that's holding your relationship back, talk it out, try to find some real peace.
Planning a wedding and it never happening was such a burning hot issue at one point that I'm kind of nervous to touch it again.
This week, I'll also be meeting with you privately. I'll be there to help you through this exercise. That's it. I'll see you guys next week.
Thank you.
Have a good one.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Something's going down, everybody talking about us.
I cannot believe you're going on a date.
I know, man. I can't believe I'm going on a date either.
No, it's like you're happy.
But I'm always happy.
No, you're happy to be going on this date.
Just knowing that I'm about to go on another date with another chick and I ain't cheating.
So you ready?
Yeah.
Ooh.
Come on, man.
You think so?
Yeah.
I thought it was gonna be hard.
Don't.
Let me see.
Don't. Man, come on, man.
I'm not gonna mess it up. I'm making it chill.
I'm just saying. You trying to mess sabotage? You getting me all wrinkly and
right?
Come on, man. Did I do all this on you? But don't.
I have mentally prepared myself to not really get upset when he's getting ready for the date, but to do it for real, I don't know. It's been 9 years, and he has put me through a lot. So if Hollywood decides he wants to mess up again, I'm out.
Come on, man. You really
talking.
You was getting Did I grab on you? I want to look my best. I want to feel refreshed, too. Trying to sabotage my first date.
Last time we spoke, you said you're still considering the do not resuscitate.
Yeah.
What happens is, if his heart stops, we have no other choice than to do CPR. And, you know, we're going to break his ribs, we're going to push on his chest, we're going to have to shock him, and it's going to be more pain and suffering for no benefit.
My father had a stroke in December, and from that, his health kind of trickled down to the point to where he had cardiac arrest, he had kidney failure. His organs were basically shutting down. It's just a lot to process.
The one thing I would ask is, if despite everything we do, his heart goes, I would say at least it's appropriate not to do CPR to force him back to life, because it would be a lot of pain for him.
Okay. My sister and I need to discuss something first before we make that decision.
I would take the time you need to consider the do not resuscitate. We just want you guys to make the right decision and make sure you feel good about it.
Okay.
Okay. Thank you, doctor.
You're welcome.
Nicole?
So what are you thinking?
It sounds like Daddy is declining. So even though it's hurting us, we don't have to be realistic that, you know, Daddy might not be here over the next couple of weeks.
Trying not to cry. I know you saw him over the iPad, but you just had to see him in person. He's so frail. He's so little.
The whole conversation is just, like, devastating. Like, my dad was my world. So, to get a call like that, I mean, I kind of was preparing myself for it, but I didn't really think that we had got to the point to where we had to make a decision like that.
I love you.
Okay, we're gonna have to make a decision.
Right now. I don't know what to say.
How I felt when I heard the news about Daddy. Heartbroken, man. Shattered to pieces.
Baby already gone.
Why are you walking away? Like, I'm trying to talk to you.
He's treating me like his own. I did not want to hear no bad news about my best friend.
Where are you going?
I had a drink.
I wish this wasn't real. I wish it was a nightmare. And I opened my eyes to find that you were right here.
Dr. Nicole is saying that Ulysses and I need to kind of lean on one another and be together. So him leaving the room was very disappointing. I really need him to just, like, stick it out, be my partner. I need you to be my backbone and my strength and be a part of what is happening right now.
I want to die here, try not to cry tears. But the mouths and the minutes, they feel like light years.
Not enough.
Dr. Nicole. Hey, how are you?
Michael, how are you?
Wonderful.
Miss Shay, how are you doing?
Good, welcome, how are you? Home.
This is wonderful. So this is the home that you've all have built together.
Yes.
I'm looking forward to a one-on-one session. Sometimes I'm a little skeptical about sharing with the full group just because I'm getting used to talking about how I feel. So this time I'm gonna try to open up more and just speak whatever's on my heart.
So like we talked about in the last session, to really think about something from the past that's holding you hostage right now. Your objective is to connect.
When we talk about the future, it's, oh, but you know, if we break up, you know, I'm over it in 24 hours. It's that lack of wanting to really just be all in.
So I don't ever want to give off the perception I don't care, but I just don't get emotional like that.
That's not gonna work for me. I need some more emotion out of him.
You want him to attach.
Yes. It frustrates me when Mike is very calm and just doesn't care about anything going on with us. It makes me think maybe he doesn't really care about me and he's not serious about us.
Growing up, I just never really let myself connect with people because I always feel like people can lead and people do lead. So emotionally, I put myself in a box where I'm okay if people leave.
We're not talking about leaving.
What he sounds like, he said, I don't want to speak for you. He got some stuff.
That she created. The first time Shay and I started dating, she still had feelings for her next boyfriend. So after a week or two, she just kind of ghosted me. Then we tried again months later, and she ghosted me again. So this is the third time we're trying this. I know she can kind of switch up and be gone at any moment.
When we first started dating and then she disappeared, and then she came back again and then she disappeared again.
Yeah.
And then when she tried to come back and pursue me, I pushed her away.
And you've been thinking about that?
I mean, it's in my head, yeah.
Are you really that stunned?
I really.
What'd you think you would find when you came back the third time?
I thought we would be great. You've never even brought this up before.
I'm saying you know what you did.
Well, I feel bamboozled. I never knew he felt that way about me ghosting in the beginning of the relationship because he's never said it before. If he showed me that he was hurt, then I would have been apologetic.
But it would be nice to see if, like, she would just take accountability.
Because you can't now want him to be affected, but then you didn't want him to be affected when you ghosted him. Don't work that way.
Yeah.
You left the first time, and you left the second time, and when you came back, what you established was you should not care when I leave.
Yeah.
If you can connect with that, you might be able to connect with where he is.
So when does he forgive me for this stuff? We move forward, because obviously now I'm ready.
When he can be vulnerable and know that you can be trusted.
So do you trust me now?
I don't know. I mean, I can't sit there and say that I trust that you'll never leave. That's why I don't really want to get married.
He's telling you, because some things went down and they weren't quite corrected.
Yeah.
This is what you've been asking for.
It is.
Let all that Michael is willing to share and all that he finds, let that flow and acknowledge it, affirm it. You might get to see more of it.
I'm Brencia. I'm a really genuine person. I love family. I'm spiritual. I'm looking for someone who wants to have a good time, someone that's funny. I really need a nice smile. And I really like somebody who's athletic. They can really protect me and hold me. Hello.
How you doing?
I'm good.
All right, what's your name?
I'm Brencia, like Valencia.
I'm Hollywood.
But would that be nice to meet you?
Nice to meet you. We like to hug in New Orleans.
Absolutely, we do.
Yeah, come on. We got a little spot over here.
How about that?
First of all, you're very beautiful.
Well, thank you. I appreciate that.
I'm trying to keep my eyes up because, you know, the goal right now for me is to see if this is what I really want with my girl, Ash, because if I can make a connection with somebody, that means that I ain't really ready to be married. So I gotta see if I'm really, really happy, happy.
Why you ain't got no man? You crazy, huh?
No.
No, it's too crazy. This is the crazy way I'm...
Why we gotta be crazy just because you don't have a man? Like,
I'm gonna
why
tell you why.
That?
The crazy I'm thinking is either when your man don't answer the phone, you blowing him up.
Never.
Or
that's a negative.
You see his car and you go scratch it up.
Negative.
Good girl.
Serious. No, queens don't chase nobody. I am extremely attracted to Hollywood. He was athletic build, which I love, and he had a really, really nice smile. That gets me every time.
It's been almost over 8 years since I had a date.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
8 years? Okay, you gotta tell me why.
I had a girlfriend.
Okay.
And I had proposed to her, but I was scared and I kept pushing away and kept pushing away.
Well, you know, you will be the one to break that cycle.
And that's what it is.
You really will be the one.
That's my goal.
Yeah.
What's that? That's for us?
Ooh, thank you so much.
See dressings?
Yes, please. I appreciate that. Thank you.
Father God, we just want to say thank you. Thank you for this opportunity.
Thank you
for
God.
This date. Thank you for meeting this nice woman. You dig? In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. And you pray. I love it.
But it took me a minute to be this guy that I am right now. I'm going to be straight up with you. No, I used to be that guy in the party biting girls on the booties and having
biting
fun.
Biting on the booty?
College.
I love intimacy. I love sex.
Ooh-wee, you just got my legs shaking. She says she loves sex, and y'all know I love sex.
What I'm saying is, what I believe, I need to be married. Because I'm not about to be just handing out like samples in a food court. Like, we don't do that.
Sometimes the samples, you gotta see if it's good to buy. I'm just joking now. I just wanna make you smile, that's it. The date was cool. She had a nice smile, good teeth. She was pretty. We had good interaction. Honestly, what I learned about going on this date with this person was I still got it going on.
My name is Riley. I'm wifey material because naturally I'm nurturing and caring and loving. I'm looking for a gentleman, someone who is caring and just a good person. Hi.
Hey, good to meet you.
Nice to meet you too. I'm Riley.
You look beautiful, Riley.
Thank you, you look nice too.
I love a girl that can with low haircut and still just bang. Overall, I'm just excited to go through the process and see if there's somebody out there I can connect with.
So you from here, from Atlanta?
I'm originally from Kansas City, Missouri.
I've been out to Kansas City once.
You gotta come. We got some good barbecue. You're
I know. That's
out.
The only thing I heard is good out there, though.
No, we have good ladies.
Okay, I see. Yeah. So I do work out. That's very important.
I like to work out too.
Yeah, you look like you. You look like you definitely.
Ah, you checked me out. I like it. Yeah.
How's dating been in Atlanta for you?
Dating in Atlanta is tough. It seems like everybody wants to share.
So you want something like that solid and long term?
Yeah, I mean,
get married.
You don't get tired of like different people thing. That's like, oof.
Yeah.
What are you looking for in
what
a
am
relationship
I looking for? So I would like to keep it a little light for a while. Mm-hmm. I'm not necessarily looking to get married right away.
I'm not definitely not like in a rush. I want to take my time because I'm only doing it one time.
And that's the same thing with me. So it's like, I just want to do it one time with this one person.
With the right person.
With the right person.
At the right time.
The right time.
Right.
And, you know, that right time is just sometimes it's different for different people.
Yeah.
You know, Dr. Nicole might know what she's talking about.
Okay.
Mike going on a date really bothers me. It makes my stomach hurt. It's always in the back of my head that maybe we're not where I want us to be at this point because he needs more time to date and see other people and see what's out there. And that scares me.
Yeah, on this one for a little date. He's about to come up in here acting like it was the best thing. Oh, girl, he is coming in right now.
What's that?
What's going on? Oh, no, I don't want no kiss.
I didn't meet a date, so I ain't even tripping.
All right. How was the date?
It was straight. I ain't even much mad at her.
Tell me about it.
I ain't feel on her booty. I ain't kiss.
Hello.
I'm just telling you the thing that I didn't do so you could be, like, cool.
I feel like she gonna be relieved because she know how I used to be and she know how I get on a date. You know, I'm very touchy-feely. She don't know if I'm being my old self or I'm being a person that she wants me to be.
Were you attracted to her?
She was pretty.
Okay.
But it wasn't like when I saw you and I was like, damn, mm-hmm. I want that.
You ain't gotta compare me.
I'm not comparing you, but I'm giving you an example. It wasn't when I saw her, I wasn't like, damn, I wanna have her. Mm-hmm. It was just like, she was cool.
All that's good, but I gotta be 100% honest. It saddens me that I could be okay with you going on a date with another girl and be happy you had a good time.
So that's what's up, like that's real.
That kind of hurt me a little bit because I know how I felt when she went on a date. And that mean I had like a little bit of jealousy in me. That made me feel like she didn't care.
But I don't like that. I don't like that that's how I feel. It bothers me because that just reassures me that a part of our connection is a little damaged. What if it's my emotions are becoming a little detached? That's not good.
I already told you, either we gonna be together at the end of this or not. So it's whatever with me, you dig?
I don't want it to be whatever.
It's gonna be that, but you talking about it don't make you feel some type of way.
I don't need you. I don't need you to puff. Don't puff, because you
start
puffing.
But I'm gonna give
puffing.
You me.
I know, but you're gonna start puffing, and that's not what I need.
I'm not puffing. I like when you say that because that don't do nothing but spark me up.
Exactly, that's what I'm saying. You're puffing.
I'm ready to get sparked. Now it's making me more happier to know when I go on my next date, I can be a little more relaxed because I was really still thinking I'm cheating.
My only thing is I want to be able to be honest with you.
And I like that.
And I want to be able to express my feelings without you puffing and flipping.
I don't want the boundaries no more. If you want to hold a hand, hold a hand. If you want to kiss, kiss. If you want to hug, hug. I ain't feeling it no more. Like, go out there and see what's out there.
I'm gonna go take a shower. Have a great day.
How you doing, Doctor?
This. Very nice.
The news about my father has been very, very difficult for us to deal with. I'm definitely looking forward to speaking with Dr. Nicole, so that she could actually kind of give us some coaching and some healthy feedback as far as he's concerned and just where to go from here, because this is, you know, something that I've never had to deal with.
How you guys doing?
As far as my father, it's come to the point to where they're saying, well, we need to make a decision to, you know, remove him off of the ventilator and stuff, so.
This is the biggest decision you guys will probably ever make together.
I'm not ready for that.
So how are you guys communicating through this?
I really ain't been able to speak how I feel about it because the most important thing is worrying about the she okay first. And you know, that really I'm just trying to stay strong.
Yeah.
It's just hard. Like my father was my everything. Like he...
Yeah. Yeah.
The thought that I even have to make a decision like this. It's like, I mean, just to have someone put that on you to end the life of your parent, like, it's just not fair to have to make a decision like that. It's not, none of it's fair.
It's supposed to be challenging because a transition is coming.
I don't know what to say. It's just my best.
Let it out. I got you. Go on and let it out.
I ain't had no dad.
Yeah.
He told me I got a dad.
My dad got arrested and he went off for 25 years. So Mimi's father step up and be a dad to me. It just helped me feel like life ain't that bad after all.
This is a life and death decision. He needs his children and his children need each other. You need to be with your sister so that you can decide in peace. Remember, after this stage shifts, you all still have to be with each other.
And be right here every step of the way.
You got more support than you think.
When Ulysses comforts me, I'm like, okay, you're getting it a little bit. I see, you know, that you're putting your personal emotions and feelings to the side and just being there for me because I need you the most right now.
It's my father's wish to make sure that we're on one accord and we came together, so he would definitely be proud.
I believe y'all have everything you need if you just hold on to each other. I wish you guys more blessings than I know how to articulate.
Welcome back.
It's nice to see you all again.
Me too.
You made it through another day.
Right. Right off the jump, I'd like to acknowledge why Mimi and Ulysses are not with us today. As you heard in our last group session, Mimi's father is gravely ill. This week, I had a private session with them, and we came to the understanding that it would be best for them to discontinue this process.
I was devastated to see Ulysses and Mimi go because they were part of the family.
And it's a certain energy I think every couple brings to this experience. Mm-hmm. And we were used to having that energy no matter how loud and crazy Ulysses was. It's weird to not have him there.
I know I speak for all of us in wishing them well, in them pushing through it together and as a family.
Yeah, definitely.
With that said, let's get into it. Gentlemen, let's hear about your first dates with someone new. So, Mr. Hollywood, how was your first date with Bernicia?
I got myself together, you know, at the crib, opened up my fresh pack of drawers and everything.
Oh,
I
had
I
was ready.
Fresh, ready.
I mean, my drawers stayed fresh, but I had that new pack on.
I
wanted to feel comfortable.
New.
Okay.
But I was kind of nervous, Doc, because I've been with her for so long, I didn't even know if I still had game, you know? But when she walked up, she was very pretty. And I know we said we wasn't gonna do the hugging and kissing and stuff. You know, I had to get a kiss. I just wanted to see how soft I was. No, I'm just playing.
Look, I did not flinch.
No, I'm just playing. No, I did hug, you know? Yeah. So what I liked about her was she was spiritual like me. She was listening to everything I said. And she said she was very sexual, and you already know what it is. I'm very sexual. I'm always hot and ready. Baby, little Caesars, you feel me? Like, I'm always ready. And Ash is sexual, but I'm way there.
If it's not right with us, that affects me.
Right now, me and Ash are on the same page, but it's like she holding it back because she feel like I'm just getting the milk without buying a cow. And she always tell me that.
Ashley, how was the experience for you?
When he came back, I told him, a part of me, it scares me that I'm that okay with him going out on a date. You know, and I know that kind of confirms to me that a part of our little connection that we have is a little damaged.
Yeah.
Because I feel too comfortable with him going.
Okay. Give yourself room that could be for a lot of different reasons.
Yeah.
Right? When you're younger, everything is about control. As you get older, you're starting to figure out what your needs are. And when something happens that throws you off, you start to unplug some of the live wires. Mm. You unplug because you don't want to be left. You unplug because you're not sure. That doesn't mean the wire is dead. It just means the wire is unplugged.
Yeah.
So if everything is unplugged to make sure I don't get hurt, make sure we don't revisit where we've been, then we can't get a full reading of what's really going on. Michael, you went on a first date with Riley. How did it go?
It was really cool. I mean, she's a beautiful woman. It was fun to just get someone else's energy a little bit, just see how people are. Like, you know, she worked out, so she had a nice body. She had a beautiful smile. Just overall, solid.
Shay, how was the experience for you?
I was a little bit more worried than he was. It was a very long date, or so it seemed. At one point, I was like, is he like spending the night somewhere or something? Like, yeah, what is going on? So I had to kind of reassure myself, okay, he's not going to leave you just from going on a date.
Yeah, she's like that a lot. Like, if we get into an argument, she'll ask me if I'm about to break up with her. Like, all the time. It's always like, I wasn't even thinking that.
I feel like if he really just called out the great things about me and why he wanted to be with me for life, then I would feel more secure.
What would you say were some points of synergy?
We have similar sense of humor.
Oh, okay.
She's very family-oriented and very thoughtful. She gave me a very calm energy, like a comforting energy. I just feel like if we ever had any disagreements, we'd find ways to solve it in a very chill, relaxed way.
You're thinking too deep.
I'm just saying, that's the type of energy she gave. At the end, we just toasted to getting to know each other and...
When? When you gonna be doing that?
It's just funny to me to see her kind of squirm a little bit because she just thinks she's so cool. It wasn't a big deal to me. It's just a date. It's not like I'm trying to marry the girl.
Hey, it's honesty. Be free.
I'm calm, too, sometimes. So, I wish him the best. That's what I do. I wish him the best in his...
You're not being authentic, and you know that's not going to help. You want him to be not honest?
Yeah, I'm just saying
I want him to be honest, but I would have liked for him not to like it, but I guess he did.
So what does that mean now?
I think she's just going to try to get me back and maybe try to get me in my feelings one day.
He's still smitten. He's okay, too smitten for me.
He's too smitten.
Yeah.
Well, well, now.
Well, no, well, then you can touch your own feet.
Okay. All right.
I would have liked for him not to like it, but I guess he did.
Well, well, now. This is such space. Well, so you can touch your own seat. Okay.
Right.
Remember, whether or not Hollywood is honest with you, you're honest with him, or the same over here, doesn't stop the person from having the individual experience they're having.
Right.
If you're really trying to co-create something, you want to stay connected as much as possible. Versus creating something else because you may not want the truth.
I agree with that.
On the money.
But guys, gone on a first date with someone new. Now time to decide if the person is right for you or if you want to move on. Hollywood, let's start with you. Will Bernicia get a second date?
And she was cool to me, but she didn't give me that firecracker spark I was looking for. Like, I need that spark when I first see you. And I am a booty man. I like women who have booty. You dig? Like,
okay.
And that was the only downfall. Like,
that was the only thing.
So I'm gonna pass on that one.
Okay. How do you feel about his decision, Ashley?
I'm all for it. If he doesn't want it, I'm behind him.
All right, Mike and Shay. Michael, would you like to go on a second date with Riley?
Honestly, the initial spark, it wasn't there. And I don't think it's gonna be there. It's either there or it's not. You know, I'm looking for something more than that.
I am so happy Mike is not going on another date with Riley.
He's so extra. Dr. Nicole said, only go on a date if you really feel a connection. So, I don't.
I didn't want him to go on a second date, and I'm ecstatic.
You funny.
Outside of the dates, I asked you to address a persistent issue from the past.
Yeah.
The idea was to talk it through and commit to action to help you move beyond something that was holding your relationship hostage. Were you able to do that?
My issue is emotion has never really been part of my life. Just kind of like my relationship with my parents. My parents don't say I love you and stuff like that. And so with her, it's like, I feel like I'm connected to her, but not really super emotionally connected to her.
And then in her leaving or her ghosting, how did that?
It just gave me confirmation that I should continue to have that wall up.
So at first, I was thinking he was being dramatic. But in our talks, I feel like he's serious about that, and that's something that's really holding us back is me not being apologetic about it or not acknowledging his feelings. So it's something that I am going to have to work on, and then he can forgive me. I can be responsible for ghosting in the beginning of the relationship. What I don't want to do is let someone overdo the pain that I've caused them.
If you step on my foot, who gets to say when my foot stops hurting?
Exactly. You. But if you take a whole year, the doctor said you're fine. I don't think you can keep hanging on to this.
I'm learning that Shay has a tendency to be dismissive. I think now that Shay wants more, it's gonna be hard just because she's helped create an environment where I don't necessarily want to get that deep with her.
If he tells you something hurts, you gotta take responsibility for it. Otherwise, he will not be able to register that you won't do it again.
I can do that. I never really realized how dismissive I was over Mike's emotions and that that may have affected him shutting down and not letting me in. But now that I am changing, I hope that we'll make our relationship stronger and he'll open up to me more.
What was the issue for the two of you?
For us, it was the point where he called off the wedding. And that's really stopping me from moving forward.
Well, the thing is, I pull out the works, too.
But he'll do all of that, but then flip side, he'll say something or do something that's contradictory to what he did, and it negates everything.
I've been trying my hardest to do whatever I can to show her, and it's still been years, right? If you're gonna keep waiting these years, then we might as well just be cooling and stay friends and not even get married no more, because I've been trying so long, and she's just still taking her time.
You can't manage how she's gonna go through this.
I can get it, Doc, but see, that's why I told you I needed it, because I'm getting tired of waiting myself.
Well, what did you think that I was tired of waiting on?
Let me know.
I was ready, and that's what I get. I get a whole different person. When I was ready, you weren't, but you wanted me to be okay with that. You wanted me to sit in it, and now that I'm not, I want you to be okay and sit with that.
I am okay, but
you
I don't wait.
You puff up, and then you do that, and then I'm not safe. I have to protect myself. I don't want to feel that again.
That hurt.
You think I want to sit here and be stuck?
I'm just tired of waiting myself,
okay,
too.
Okay, well, don't wait. Don't wait.
That's what I'm saying.
Don't
Let me
wait.
Know. We can leave right now. You dig? I'm out there. Right. I don't right. need this. You dig?
Are you?
Exactly.
Wait a minute. It's about the vision of where you see your life going.
I saw it with her.
Okay. Manage yourself, because your words, they have life. So if you say, I saw it, that's in past tense.
Yep.
What she's looking for is some safety. When you speak in anger, you push yourself further back than where you started. You're going in reverse.
Man, I do that because it's a defense mechanism, man. Like, I be really shutting down sometimes when she keep telling me bad about myself.
Well, you gotta change that.
I know, that's why I'm here. I'm working on it.
I know,
right
I'm
now.
Just saying, you have to change it.
A man protects the temperature in his house.
But see all this, like this ad-libbing?
I'm going ahead.
Shaking
that's
the
me.
Head,
you
that's
don't worry about that.
I don't be wanting to hear all that. I don't be wanting to see all that.
Yeah, she don't want to hear a lot of things too, Hollywood.
And if she don't want to hear that, stop it.
Consistency gives you a shot, because you are the thermostat. If you keep going over there and moving it, one minute is 60, the next minute is 70, the next minute is 85, and then you're like, why the hell is it hot?
Right.
I can do my part. I'm gonna be straight up with
you. That's all that I need you to do.
If that's really what you want.
If, hold tight. You gotta manage your mouth too.
I know.
Cause you know, it ain't no fun to have a day pass from jail, and then the minute I do something, you put me right back in there.
Bingo.
Listen. Actually, you have to have a starting point to try to co-create something different.
Think about that.
Okay.
See? Control.
That's my feeling.
Says, I'm still fuming.
Because I am.
We're gonna have to decide what you wanna do with it.
I have to learn how to let go. I'm stubborn, and I see that it is holding
hindering the relationship. If she quiet, then I know it's trouble. So as long as she running that mouth, because she can run that mouth, I'm good.
My goal is to help each of you make the best decision at the end of this process. Speaking of the group, though, we got a couple of empty chairs. I think it's important to have them filled so everyone can learn from other points of view. So I've invited a new couple to join us. And they're arriving right now.
What?
What?
What? Okay.
That's cool.
This week, things are stepping up a notch. All of you will be going on dates with other people.
It's funny, your relationship, but how's your heart?
I want it to move forward. And if it doesn't, then, you know.
Okay, I like these strong hands, sir.
So how's that feel?
Amazing.
This guy is just a take charge kind of man. It's very sexy.
Are you letting your man go out on a date with
me? I just think it's really messed up.
Oh man, here we go.
Bye. I will never have my daddy walk me down that aisle. Never.
I'm tired of telling you I've been ready, and you
keep. I understand you're ready. I'm not.